Okay, so we're going to replace the gas spring for this Carefree awning. It's a traveler style from Carefree of Colorado. This awning is just about 18 feet, and here is the gas spring that we're going to be replacing. Okay, so these are the instructions for replacing the gas shock, and I found these instructions on the Carefree of Colorado website, which is the manufacturer for this awning. And so the first step is to open the awning. The second step is highlighted here, which is to remove the stop bolts. Okay, so here are the stop bolts just above the lower arm assembly. Okay, so here we are removing the stop bolts. Okay, next step is to remove the drive screws from the end cap and pull the arm away from the roller. Okay, so here's the end cap, and these are square drive screws. One is on the top of the cap and the other is on the bottom. Okay, before I unscrew the cap, I just want to put some alignment markings so that I reassemble the cap with the roller properly. Okay, so we have the arm separated from the roller, and Ollie has the roller secured at the top of the ladder. Okay, we're gonna unscrew the shock now, according to these instructions.
So that is separating from the clevis there.
Okay, so we have the rod side of the gas spring separated from the clevis, and now we need to begin to unscrew the cylinder side. We did have to get creative and use a ratcheting tool to compress the scissoring action of the awning arm to create a greater distance between the clevises on either end of the gas spring. You'll understand the need for this when you go to install your own gas spring. So to get the correct replacement gas spring, Carefree required only one measurement, and it was of the wall bracket that you mount the awning arm to, and you measure it from the top all the way to the bottom. And in this case, it was 59 inches.
Okay, we got the new rod right out of the bag.
Okay, so we're gonna thread this, the end of this cylinder side into the clevis, and then we'll do it the same for the rod end. Notice I'm wearing rubber gloves. These allow you to have a good grip, get a good grip on the rod side of the gas spring and thread it completely into the clevis. Okay, so the gas spring is installed, and now we are attaching the arm of the awning, the arm and cap assembly to the roller, and you can see that we're fastening that cap to the roller. The cap is properly aligned with the roller according to our markings, and so this should work good. Okay, so we have the gas springs installed. We actually, everything I showed you on the video will be times two. You know, this is the gas spring that we replaced in the video, and they're tensioning this awning real nice. But this particular awning has two gas springs, and that's the other one. We replaced that at another time, but that's it. That's the procedure. This is what you get. We retract that now, Andrea. We can see it working. Retract. And it retracts nice too.